Hello and welcome back to my channel, or welcome to my channel. I'm Lioness, Lion, male. But you can also call me Fox or Sandy, which is my real name. And these are my thoughts, quick thoughts, on Eurovision Song Contest 2023, second semi-final. Just like with the first semi-final thought video, my thoughts, I don't have a lot to say, and there are some performances I have more to say about and some I have nothing to say about at all. So that's that, again getting that out of the way. And let's start with taking a quick peek at the recap of the second semi-final.
You're not a star.
So, that was the recap. Again, I'm gonna have to flip through it like the previous time because my memory is bad. So, the first one we had Dryly from Denmark with song Breaking My Heart. Sorry, I can't even read. I can't read either. about the performance, I like the new performance better than their national selections performance. It feels kind of more professional, more kind of more ready, more done. Yeah. Also, I see inspiration from last year's entry of which country was it? Snap. The song by name Snap. Rosalind, and she's from, I can't remember. Anyways, you know what I'm talking about. He had so many notes off. Like the singing, the vocals was not clear. It was kind of off. So that's that. Next, quickly, so you don't have to sit here for 10 hours again. Next is Armenia, Brunette and Future Lover. I liked her staging better than the one I was reacting to. I don't remember if it was the music video or was it the national selection. This one I liked a lot better, and the camera work is very well as well. I liked that part where the white light switched on and then off. Well, projection, judging by the snippet we have here on this recap, it was a panel for projections, and that was a projection of something white, and then it was switched off, and then just light shined, turned on her side. So that I like that. Yeah. Next, Romania, Theodore Andrei and DGT or Degete. What a disappointment for me personally. For me personally, this looked and felt like a total downgrade. The national selections performance was way more interesting, way better for me, way more capturing. Of course, EBU won't allow girls in lingerie and stuff like that on the stage, but way too plain for my tastes. So with performance like this, I'm not mad Romania did not qualify. That's that. Next, quickly. Estonia, Alika and Bridges. I don't see big changes, well, except the dress and lighting and lack of cellist on the stage, but other than that, it's pretty much the same performance that it was on the national selection. It's fine with me, it's good. I really like her voice. I caught myself just wowing over her voice. So yeah, that's that. I'm happy they qualified. And next, Belgium, Gustav and Because of You. Again, the biggest improvement, the biggest change of the performance is the dancer. Other than that, for me, it doesn't seem that much different. I liked it before, I like it now. So that's that. And I'm happy they qualified as well. Next, we have Cyprus with Andrew Lambrow and Break a Broken Heart. My cutie also qualified. The performance, well, I can't compare because I wasn't able to find the national selections performance when I was blind reacting to the song, to this entry. So I have no idea, is it upgrade or downgrade? Is it an upgrade or a downgrade? But yeah, I don't have much to say about that. Except that, oh, my cutie is in. Next, Iceland, Dilja, and Power. The way she sprang up, oh sorry, I'm pulling on cords here. This is my mic cord, made it, Mr. Mike. Okay. So the way she sprang up when, from the floor with that one handstand and flip, whoa! I didn't expect that. That was so cool, like really cool. Other than that, I didn't notice big changes in the performance. Maybe it's just my memory issue, an issue of my memory, but I didn't notice any big changes, so yeah, it was fine before, it's fine now. But the flip and the kick and all this athletic stuff, that was cool. Next, Greece, Viktor Vernikos and What They Say. I'm not sure what to say about this performance. What do they say about it? I don't know. Again, I can't compare because I didn't find the national selection's performance on YouTube so that I could react to it when I was doing the blind reactions. So I can't compare. Comparing to the video, music video, I like the music video better. But he has a lovely voice. Yeah, I could allow him to tell me stories day long. Okay, but about the performance, I don't know. Again, yeah, this might be one of those I don't have much to say about. Next, or pretty much anything at all to say. Poland, Blanka and Solo. With this performance, it gives me 90s Mean Girls vibe. Like Mean Girls with Regina George, but a few years back in the history. Ow, this would be the site. My phone flips it, so I have to learn that past is not on my left, past is on my right, so that it looks like on the left, so past, present, future. Back to the topic. I'm so scattered all over the place tonight. So, this feels, as I said, like Mean Girls, but from the past. I don't remember, did they have this dance part in the national selection? I don't think they had. I don't remember. Did they? Anyway, if they didn't, that's a noticeable change in the performance. If they did have it, that's a noticeable change in my memory. Yeah. Other than that, I don't know. There's nothing much for me to say. Yep, next. Next, oh my boys, Joker out from Slovenia and song Carpe Diem. Oh my god, the way they performed their song. I caught myself thinking, oh shit. How many are there? Okay. One evening, two evenings, a week? Don't mind me, I'm a weirdo. A spicy weirdo. Anyways, I liked how they filled up the stage. Their camera work plus their choreo, let's put it that way, the stage placement made it feel like it's a full stage. Not like just a few guys here and there, but like a full stage. They made it size adequate. They sized themselves up. I don't know how to describe what I'm trying to say, but it looked I don't remember that word, so I'm gonna say it looked good. Also, they are good. Next, Georgia, Iru and Echo. From this performance, I liked the most the part that's in the snippet with these blinking gold-ish lights. Other than that, I can't compare because I couldn't find this entry's national selection's performance either, so it's not fair to compare a live performance to a video, music video. So I'm not gonna do that. I'm just gonna say that I liked that part, the one that's in the snippet with these blinking lights. Next, San Marino picked Jax and Like an Animal. Again, also, no, come on. I don't have much to say about this either. I did not feel like there were big changes. Yeah, that's that. Next. Oh, too far. Oh, Austria, Taya and Selena, and who the hell is that girl? Oh, I liked this so much. And I very much liked that audience joined in on the po-po-po-po-po-po part. So that's cool. And I'm really, really, really happy they qualified. Yes. What more to say? I don't know. Nothing. It's just cool and happy. I'm really happy about them. So, yes. Next. Albania with Albina and Familia. Oh, jeez. It's blurry. I can't read. Give me a second. Familia Kilmendi? I can't read. And a song by Name Duje from Albania. Oh, this is the only song in this year's Eurovision Song Contest from both semi-finals that has given me goosebumps and shivers. The only song. The very, very one song. That's impressive because that's a very good sign. That's a sign that, I don't know, my body reacts to the song on a deeper level, I guess. Because bopping along with the song is a simple response. When you get these goosebumps all over your body, not goosebumps, the shivers all over your body when you feel like there's that feeling that something is kind of running up and down and sideways on your body. That's a powerful response to a music that doesn't happen often, at least for me personally. And this is the song that it happened to. The only song this year. Also, I'm very, very happy they qualified. Very happy. It was really powerful. Also, I'm happy to see that this sister that in the national selection's performance I saw was singing with that kind of scared face or something. This time she was more alive, happier. So that's that. Next we have Lithuania, Monika Linkytė and Stay. Well, for this one, there is a lovely improvement for the performance. I saw these drawings on the screens on the background, and there were these goddesses and there were these signs and symbols, and I like this stuff and I'm happy they used this stuff, and these symbols and the drawings and signs and goddesses, because it just made the song feel more powerful, but not like aggressively powerful, like, but kind of, I don't know how to put it. More rooted inside the body, like more connected. Maybe that's because Latvians have similar these signs and symbols, maybe. I don't know. Maybe that's the reason. Next, Also, I'm happy they qualified. Oh, we have our last entry, and it's Australia and Voyager with the song Promise. And who? Back to the Future? Who? I called it with that car, you know. I'm also happy they qualified. I can't compare again because I couldn't find their national selections performance video, so can't compare. There wasn't a car in their music video, so that's new. Anyways, yeah, they're good. I like them, and I'm happy they qualified. Mm-hmm. From the ones that did not qualify, I would like to see Greece qualify with Viktor Bernikos and What They Say, because of the meaning of the song, because it's familiar to me, the feeling and all that stuff, and it's quite a lot of my feelings myself, etc, etc. But other than that, I'm really happy with all the qualifiers. Yeah, I guess that's all. Thank you for watching my almost said blind reaction. Well, that's a power of habit. Thank you for watching my thoughts on Eurovision Song Contest 2023 second semi-final. Yeah, what else do I say? I don't know. Maybe the problem is that it's 3:22 a.m. Maybe that's the reason I don't know what to say. Anyways, ooh! Get your shit together, babe! Thank you for watching, and I'm not gonna repeat all the stuff about liking and subscribing. If you want to, you will. If not, who am I to tell you what to do? But there's this one thing I will tell you what to do, and it is to have a lovely, amazing day, you gorgeous, beautiful human being. And I guess see you around, but probably not with Eurovision content until next year's spring. I think so. Let's see what I come up with for this channel. Or if I come up with anything at all, or nobody knows the future, me neither. So thank you, enjoy your day, and see you around. Bye!